A very good morning, everyone. I hope you all are well. So today we will start our new chapter of social science, that is Indian heritage and culture. In this chapter we will study about the heritage and culture of India. So let's start. So before starting, we'll clear the meaning of heritage. What is heritage? Heritage refers to things and traditions which are passed down through the years from one generation to the next. So what is the meaning of heritage? That means the things and the traditions which is passing down through the years from the one generation to the other, that is heritage. The things and traditions which are passed down from so many years and from one generation to the other. We will study the meaning of culture. What is culture? It refers to practices and traditions followed by our ancestors. That means the practices and the traditions which is followed by our forefathers, or we can say our grandparents or great grandparents, that is known as our culture. Now, what is architecture? It is the art and science of designing building. So, what is architecture? This is an art and science through which the architects they design the buildings. So, now we will study more about the architecture. During Harappan times, the baked bricks were used to construct houses. So if we talk about the ancient period, in the Harappan times the baked bricks were used to construct houses, and in the ancient time the Buddhist monasteries and the temples, their architectures were also used, and their architectures were used with the sculptures. And if we talk about the medieval period, the architecture of the medieval period, in the medieval period, domes or the semicircular roofs, like in the picture you can see the dome shape, the circular shape above the building, you can see that is the Indo-Islamic architecture. But in the modern period, when the Britishers were in the India, the form of architecture changed, and we can see the British influence in so many buildings. Like I think you, if you have visit, or you might have seen about the Chhatrapati Shivaji Terminus, that is in Mumbai, there you can see the British influence and the architecture of British. So these are some example of the architecture. Now we will study about the literature. So what is literature? It is defined as the written material. So literature means the written material. And if we talk about the Indian literature, in Indian literature or in Indian literature heritage, we have the two types of literature. One is religious and the one is non-religious. The religious, that means which is related to the religion, and the non-religious, that is related to the other parts, like that is related to the king or the common people, that doesn't belong to the religion. So in the religious books, we'll just read about the religious facts, like the Vedas, the Ramayana, the Mahabharata, the Puranas. These are some religious texts. And the languages used in the religious and the non-religious books are the Sanskrit, Pali, Prakrit, Dravidian, Persian, Arabic, Urdu, Hindi, and so many languages others are used for writing literature, that is writing religious and the non-religious books. So now we will study more. So there are some example of literature, and Mahabharata and the Ramayana, these are some important literature that is related to the religion. So now we will study about the languages. As we know, in India we speak so many languages, so many dialects are there. So what is dialect? A dialect is the way of speaking a language restricted to a particular area or a particular group. So what is dialect? That means when they are speaking a language but it is restricted to a particular area and a particular group, that is the dialect. And in the India we have the 22 scheduled languages, and out of that 22 scheduled language, some are the Assamese, Bengali, Gujarati, Hindi, Kannada, Kashmiri, Konkani, Malayalam and the Manipuri. So now we will study about the paintings. Thousands of years ago, cave dwellers in India painted on cave walls. So if we talk about the thousands of years ago, at that time the cave dwellers, those who lived in the caves, how they expressed themselves? They expressed themselves while painting on the caves. But in the medieval period, the miniature paintings were introduced. Miniature, that means they were small in size if we compare it to the normal paintings. But in the modern period, for the Indian history, other painting designs were introduced, and some important, some well-known painters were the Raja Ravi Varma, Abindranath Tagore and the Amrita Shergill. These are some important paintings, as you can see. Now we will study about the music. Hindustani and the Carnatic music, they are the main forms of the classical music in India. And in the classical music, what instruments are used? The instruments which are used in the classical music are tabla, sitar, flute and sarod. And India, it has a rich tradition of regional music, but it has a rich tradition of folk music also. The regional music is also there and folk music is also there. And that folk music is played on a certain occasions or the certain events like the birth and the marriages. And some regional music are also there, and some examples of regional musics are the Lotiya of Rajasthan, Rasiya Geet of Uttar Pradesh, Mando of Goa and Amanaveri of Tamil Nadu. Here are some musical instruments. Now we will study about the dances. As we know, India is famous for their dances, and different dances are there in India, and several dance forms, they are mentioned in an ancient book, that is Natya Shastra. And we have the seven major classical dance styles of India. These are Bharatanatyam from Tamil Nadu and Karnataka, Kathakali, that we know a dance form from the Kerala, Manipuri, that is from the Manipur, Kathak from the Uttar Pradesh, Odissi from the Odisha, and Kuchipudi from Andhra Pradesh, and Satriya from Assam. These are several major classical dance forms of Bharatanatyam. Instead of that, we have folk dances also. Like the folk dances, if we talk about the Punjab, we have Gidda and Bhangra. If we talk about the Gujarat, we have Garba and Dandiya. And in Rajasthan, we have the folk dances, that is Ghumar and Nautanki. These are some important and well-known dances, folk dances of the regions. So now we will study about the UNESCO World Heritage Sites in India. In India, we have 38 UNESCO World Heritage Sites as on August 2019. These are the heritage sites by the UNESCO. Railways in India, as we know, India is famous for their railways, and it has made the transportation easy. And this is also introduced by the Britishers. So thank you. I hope the chapter is clear to you.